For additional perspective on this new high-speed train, I spoke to Eva Grey. She's a features writer with Future Rail magazine.
In a way, they are showing their prowess at home after years of being involved in various huge high-speed rail infrastructure projects throughout Asia and throughout the world. Of course, we do have to keep in mind the One Belt, One Road initiative, which is this huge undertaking. So after giving a huge financial backing and political push for those projects, they seem to be returning their attention to home.
So the next question is, obviously the people in China are going to be the beneficiaries of this. What does it mean for them? How does this impact the Chinese population?
This route serves 100 million passengers a year, 500,000 a day, huge numbers of passengers. Obviously, on such a crowded line where there's a shortage of tickets, I'm sure that shaving off that half an hour will help to ease congestion and will benefit all these passengers.
The Associated Press wrote recently that China spent an estimated $360 billion on a high-speed rail, building by far the largest network in the world. And here in the United States, we've watched California Governor Jerry Brown make a couple of trips to China. He's marveled at this technology. He wants to put in high-speed rail, which could deliver passengers from San Francisco to Los Angeles in less than 3 hours. Can China's advancements be a blueprint for others, do you think?
I'm sure they would like to think so. I mean, one of the reasons I take it for them to patent this this technology is the fact that they are eager to export the high-speed rail technology in other countries. I know that they'd be interested to export it maybe to countries like Russia and certainly neighboring Asian countries, which China has really close ties with. Especially in the rail sector. I'm not sure about how they're going to go about selling it to U.S. soil, but we shall see.
Yeah, let me ask you about Belt and Road because you brought it up. How does this fold into that whole initiative? Because it's so sprawling, infrastructure, rail, so many ports. We've talked about this quite a bit on our network. But how do you see this as fitting into that puzzle?
They have thrown immense political backing, huge financial input into building the One Belt, One Road, this huge undertaking. Obviously, dominating the high-speed rail market on a global level by donning the fastest bullet trains in the world. Obviously, it will probably raise their profile even further, if that's possible. Yeah, it's a huge piece of the puzzle. They are demonstrating yet again that they are committed to delivering this huge project, and they are pushing successfully forwards with it. China is consistently backing, as we speak, huge infrastructure projects, rail infrastructure projects in countries like Singapore and Malaysia. All of these ties, the trade ties between these countries and further away from the mainland, looking into Eurasia and Europe, I'm sure all of these countries will benefit from the increased business and trade that this will spur.
Eva Grey, thanks so much for your time.